Today our lecture neurotransmitters. I am Professor Alexander Dvirsky, Psychiatry Department. Now something about nerve systems. I hope you remember that nerve systems consist of some type of tissues. It's a neurons, neuroglia, blood vessels, and meninges. The peripheral nerve systems consist of something different type of cells. It's a neurons, Schwann cells, connective tissues, and blood vessels. Yes, of course, blood vessels persist in the central nervous systems too. Terminology. Now we will discuss about definitions. What does it mean? What does it mean, some terms in the neuroscience? First terms which we must which you must refresh in your memory, it's neurons. What does it mean, neurons? Neurons, it's a nerve cells. Neurons are executable cells that are specialized of the receptions of the stimulus and conductions of the nerve impulses. Other words, what does it mean, neurons? Neurons, it's a main unit in the nerve systems. Neurons, it's a CPU. Neurons, it's a CPU. What do CPU? Central processor unit. Central processor unit receive signals from one input channel, processing signal, and send signal to the output channel. Okay, input and output channel. Axon and dendrites. Yeah, we discuss about terms something more. Now you must understand our nerve systems. It's a multiprocessors systems. It's a systems which working in multi CPU systems. It's a first. Second, it's a not a digital systems. It's a not a digital systems. It's a systems which use much more flexibility. Next, information coding in the nerve systems due the ratio. Ratio depend impulses. Who do impulses? Neuron do impulses. Different input, it's impulses. Different output, it's impulses. Input signal, it's impulses. Output signal, it's impulses. Who generate impulses? I mean primary generator of impulses. It's receptors. Receptors generate impulses from surrounding from inner organs. Okay, next terms which will be discussed, it's projections of neurons. What does it mean, projections of neurons? It's very easy. Projections of neurons, it's a channel, input and output channel, which connect neurons with other neurons or with other receptors, clear? It's maybe receptors, it's maybe other neurons. In general, in the CNS, yes, of course, majority of connections, it's a connections between neurons. When we speak about peripheral nerve systems connect our receptors with neurons. I repeat once more, receptors, it's a part of neurons too. Usual receptors situated in the peripheral nerve systems, in the neurons, in the peripheral nerve systems. Interneurons, it's a special types of neurons which create a local neuronal groups. It's mean neurons which has a very short projections. Some neurons has a very long projections, very large projections. For example, it's a neurons in the pathway. Neurons in the pathway has a very wide projections because pathway, it's starting in the small nucleus into the brain and projections in the different area of brain. It's like interconnections. Interneurons, it's a neurons which create a small groups, usual interneurons, it's a groups of neurons which processing some kind of information. It's a data center. axon. Axon is an output channel. I repeat once more. Our nerve systems manipulate with information. Information in our nerve systems, it's a ratio. In general, it's a time coding. Different information, it's a different ratio, clear? Dendrites, it's an input channel. Yes, of course, input and output channel has a very same electricity parameter. I mean ratio, I mean voltage. Classifications of neurons. In general, we discuss about materials which you learn in the histology department, in anatomy department, in physiology department. Now I something brief type of neurons. What's main type of neurons? It's a unipolar neurons, it's a bipolar neurons, it's a multipolar neurons. Size of neurons, yeah? It's a Golgi type 1, Golgi type 2. Different type of axon, yes, maybe some parameters. In this picture, now you can reading this picture and maybe stop video after some times and reading more exactly this picture and refresh informations about classifications of neurons in this picture. Yes, of course, it's a very brief classifications in histology books, in anatomy books, classifications more wide, more exactly. But my opinion is enough for reading psychiatric books. In this picture, you see a main type of neurons. It's a unipolar neurons. It's a bipolar neurons. It's a multipolar neurons, yeah? I hope you see what's different, yes? In this picture present axon, dendrite, and other elements of the neurons. Unipolar neurons. Usually these neurons, it's neurons which has a short axon, and these neurons very often we can meet in the interconnect neurons for which create a local array networks in the CNS. Bipolar neurons. What's different? You see that bipolar neurons has axons in the different part of body, different part of body, yes? Unipolar neurons, it's a neurons which has a axon like situated in the one part of body and this in the two part of body. Next very important terms which will be discussed today, it's a synapse. What is a synapse? Synapse, it's the high specialized area at which neurotransmitters occurs between neurons. Transmitters is serialized at the presynaptic axon terminal and binds to the specialized receptors in the membrane of the postsynaptic target neurons. In my website, in our courses, you can meet enough video about this. You can see video about this in the internet. My recommendations, watch video about synapse. It's after that it's be more understandable. Synaptic cleft, the gap in the synapse between two neurons, clear? Okay, synapse include, it's mean two part of neurons. Synaptic cleft, it's a space between two axon, dendrite to axon, maybe, yes, it's a cleft. All communications happy in the synaptic cleft. I pay your attention. Neurotransmitters usually open yon channel. Neurotransmitters don't sending information directly. Neurotransmitters usually open yon channel and open electricity channel between two neurons. Electricity, it's a flow of the ions, potassium, kalium. Next definitions, yes, a synapse is a site where two neurons come into close proximity and where functions interneuronal communication occurs. A receptor is a protein molecule of the postsynaptic membranes. Okay, now you understand. When we speak about receptors, receptors is a something of which receive signals. What does it mean, signals? Signals, it's a neurotransmitters. I pay attention. Now we speak about receptors in the nerve systems, because in immune systems, receptors, it's a something which connect with antigen. In the nerve systems, receptors, it's a something which contact with, which contact, which binding with receptors. When receptors contact with neurotransmitters, it's open ion channel. It's open a very large flow of the events inside neurons. Now we'll be discuss about macroanatomy. CNS, central nerve systems. CNS consists of brain and spinal brain. Peripheral nerve systems. It's automatic nerves and somatic nerves. It's everything beyond spinal cord. Okay, brain and spinal cord, it's a CNS, everything's beyond, all nerve tissues beyond brain and spinal cord, it's a peripheral nerve systems. I hope it's clear for you. Somatic nerve systems. What does mean somatic nerve systems? It's a part of the peripheral nerve systems that includes the sensory and motor nerves. Okay, somatic nerve systems include receptors, include motor part of neurons, and situated into the organs. Clear? It's a part of nerve systems which integrate in other tissue. Clear? It's a like a, yes, of course, nerve systems, somatic nerve systems, it's a part of other tissue, because you remember that all tissue include nerves. Part of nerves which situated in interconnection tissue in the muscles, it's somatic nerve systems. Autonomic nerve systems, part of the peripheral nerve systems which sympathetic and parasympathetic components that control functions like a heart rate, blood pressure. Okay, what do autonomous nerve systems? Autonomous nerve systems control homeostasis in our body. Autonomous nerve systems control metabolic process in our body. Autonomous nerve systems control temperature, control blood pressure, control everything. It's a systems which control our balance. Usual disturbance in these systems after some times developing somatic diseases. Why? Because if some pathological process persists long time, after some time this balance shifting in other positions. What does mean diseases? Diseases, it's situations when balance shifting in other positions. It's like a new point of balance inside our body. You remember that present sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve systems. What does mean sympathetic nerve systems? It's a part of body which responsibility for the emergency actions, like increasing heart rate, dilated air passage in our lung, increases sweating, In general, sympathetic and parasympathetic systems has a very high role in the fight or flight. Maybe you remember, I very often speak about this, and what has been fight or flight? It's the main pattern of the behavior into the nerve systems. Because what has been our nerve systems? Our nerve systems, it's a organs which responsibility for surviving. And we has main functions. What does it mean target of our life? Target of life from the nerve system's point of view. It's a surviving, it's a pleasure. Why pleasure? Pleasure depend for nerve systems. It's a conditions when nerve systems think, maybe means, then we satisfy our target. What's our main target? Our main target, it's a homeostasis, clear. And when we full, when we have not thirsty feelings, when we satisfy our hungry, thirsty feelings, we feel pleasure. Pleasure, it's mean rewards. Our nerve systems take reward for himself, for ourselves, and push ourselves, control some kind of balance. Parasympathetic nerve systems, it's the other component of the autonomous nerve systems. This system's responsibility for the decreased heart rate, increase blood flow, and other functions. In general, sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve systems has opposite roles, clear opposite role. Sympathetic stimulates something, parasympathetic decrease some activity, and opposite. Some functions which do parasympathetics has opposite functions in the sympathetic systems. Next important terms which we must remember, it's white matter and gray matter. It's what does mean white matter? It's a part of the brain consists of the axon and include a lot of myelin. In general, it's what does it mean white matter? It's like it's like a cables, yes, it's like a lot of cables. Okay, if switch, it's a neurons, and cable, it's a white matter, clear. A lot of cable, it's a lot of white matter. A lot of switch, it's a great matter. Gray matter, it's a body of neurons. Next terms which will be discussed today, it's a cortex. What does it mean, cortex? Cortex, it's a layers in our brain which consists of from the body of neurons. Cortex has a very large surface, surface very large. And a lot of neurons, bodies situated in the cortex. In general, large cortex depend large cognitive activity. Because what does mean cognitions? A lot of our systems, every ideas, every pattern of behavior, everything which happy with ourselves, it's a conditions of nerve systems. Our nerve systems every time jumping from one conditions, from one state to other states. Numerous of state which can reflect or create nerve systems depend of the numerous of the neurons. Next terms, which touch a body of neurons, it's a ganglion. What does it mean, ganglion? It's a cluster of neuronal cells body. Which situated in the spinal cord, yes. Same things clusters of neurons which situated in the CNS has in the brain has name a nucleus. Next very important type of the tissue which is situated in the brain, it's a nerve systems in the brain, it's a glia, yes, and glia cells. It's not neuronal cells, it's not a neurons, it's like cells which support neurons. Neuroglia consist of it consists of different cells and volumes of the glia tissue in the nerve systems near the 50%. General present as three type of the glia cells. It's astrocytes, it's oligodendrocytes, and microglia. What has been astrocytes? Astrocytes not only support neurons and blood vessels, but also has some roles in the modulations of the transmission of the information. In general, astrocytes has a very high role in the neurotransmissions. And now you understand when we calculate when we calculate numerals of the neurons, it's not enough because astrocytes and neuroglia take very important roles in the neurotransmissions and conduct some kind of signals. In general, all cells which are situated in our nerve systems responsibility for neurotransmissions. And second part of this picture explain what does it mean gliosis process, yes? Now we it's a well-known fact then glutamate which released in the astrocytes has a very important role in the epilepsy and drugs like valproate, acid, gabapentin and other drugs influence to the astrocyte cells signaling. Next next role of the astrocytes, it's a blood-brain barriers. Next type of the glia, it's a microglia. What is the microglia? Same that it's a special type of tissue, yes, it's a special type of tissue which respond for like eliminate dead cells from focus of trauma. For example, it's maybe not only lesions, it's maybe a result of the hypoxia of the ischemia. In general, it's like a special macrophages which eliminate garbage from nerve system, say so. Next type of the glia cells, it's oligodendrocytes. It's they are the cells which wrap of the myelin on the axon. Why myelin very important? Myelin very important because it's influence. It's influence to the conduction of signal. It's very important cells, yes. In the peripheral nerve systems, cells which has same functions has name Schwann cells. Now some words about myelinization process. It's a very important process which starting after delivering and finishing near the 22 years ago. This process influence to the mental ability. This process influence to the motor skills. And why a child has problems with motor activity, with cognitions, has a very strong connections with level of the myelinizations. Now you understand what does mean myelinizations. Now you remember what kind of cells responsibility for the productions of the myelin. Now see to this picture. This picture explain classifications of the nerve systems. Central nerve systems, it's a brain and spinal brain. Peripheral nerve systems consist of automatic nerve systems and somatic nerve systems, yes? Autonomic nerve systems, in general, we can split to the sympathetic nerve systems and parasympathetic nerve systems. Now, very important picture. Now we will discuss about main criteria of the neurotransmissions. What does it mean? What substance we can call neurotransmitters? First, it's a substance must be stored in the presympathetic neurons. It's the first very important conditions. Next conditions, it must be realized with depolarizations of the presynaptic neurons, including by the influx of the calcium. Maybe other ions like potassium, kalium. The substance must be bind with a specific receptors on the postsympathetic neurons. Okay, now you understand that neurotransmitters, it's a substance which stored in the presympathetic neurons, yes, and it's a substance of its binding to the presympathetic neurons. In general, neurotransmitters are releasing from presympathetic neurons. We speak about two type of receptors. It's a fast receptor, chemical, and slow receptors, metabolic. Fast receptors, yes, it's these receptors influence to the open ion channel. It's a receptors which when substance binding, when neurotransmitters binding to receptors, open ion channel and neurons like present depolarizations of cells. Slow receptors. How to work slow receptors? In this picture, step by steps, I explain what's happy in the slow receptors. First stage, neurotransmitters bind to receptor. Second stage, the receptors activate the G proteins. And last stage, G protein activates the effector proteins. Effector proteins, after that, starting next flow, next cascade of metabolic process which happen in the neurons. Ratio of neurotransmitters. I ask you remember this picture. In general, main neurotransmitters in volume in our nerve systems, it's a glutamate and GABA. Other neurotransmitters like serotonin, dopamine, very very important, but usually this neurotransmitter situated only into the neurons which from which consist of pathway pathway. Why we has a lot of GABA in our nerve systems? Answer very easy. GABA present in the glial cells. Okay, I hope now you remember this picture and you take correct answer. Classifications of neurotransmitters. First, classifications depend due chemical structure. It's amines. My opinion, it's a very important substance in the mental diseases. What's main substance which has high role, high loading in the mental disorders? It's a serotonin, it's a dopamine, it's a norepinephrine, it's a epinephrine, acetylcholine, yes. This substance like a 5-HT, dopamine, norepinephrine, responsibility for the anxiety disorders. It's a serotonin, norepinephrine. Dopamine, responsibility for the rewards, for the dependence, for the psychosis like delusions and hallucinations. Okay, it's a main three first positions. It's a main neurotransmitters which has a focus of interest of the psychiatrist doctors. Next type of receptors, it's amino acids. Yeah, it's GABA, it's glycine, glutamate, aspartate, and gamma hydroxybutyrate. Okay, I ask you remember this type. Maybe you meet like these questions in your license exam when you come back to your countries. Next, it's a peptides. Peptides, it's a very specific neurotransmitters. My opinion, it's a much more better call. It's like a hormones, but all of these hormones has very strong connections with neurotransmissions. Clear, because all of these hormones realize it in the CNS and has a very high loading influence to the neurotransmissions into the brain and in the peripheral nerve systems. Hypothalamus releasing hormone. It's not a neurotransmitters, but this hormone has very strong connections with neurotransmitters. In general, neurotransmitters depend realizing of these hormones. Opioid peptides, very important role in the into the functions of the nerve systems. Now we have less knowledge than about dopamine, serotonin and connections with behavior, but now a lot of the articles about these peptides present in the World Magazine, in magazine in the World Medical Database, and I pay your attention. This opioid peptides has a very strong connections with level of the serotonin, dopamine, and take very important role in the modulations of the releasing of the neurotransmitters. Other very interesting substance, it's a substance P and neurokinins. My opinion about this substance, you must do a special lecture. It's a very intensive special topics. Now we discuss about pathway. What does mean pathway? Pathway, it's a groups of neurons which connect different area of brain. In this, numerous of these neurons very small, but these neurons has a very high role in the human behavior. Main pathway which influence to the our behavior and our cognitive process and our mental process it's a dopamine, it's a serotonin. Dopamine has a high role in the psychotic symptoms. Serotonin has a very high role in the depression and in anxiety disorders. Now we discuss about what does it mean, pathway. Yes, pathway, it's like a power line, it's like a internet cable, it's like a cable which connect different area of brain. In general, every area of brain is like a switch, and pathway, it's a cable which connect different switch. Clear, we has like a root switch which present in your hostel, which are touching with providers, and after that every level in your hostel has special cable and special switch. Okay, cable which connect different part of building, it's a pathway. Not so many, yes, of course, in your rooms much more cable, but without pathway, integration of the infrastructure of the your hostels be damaged. Clear, when we damage only one cable which connect first level, like a root switch, with your level, and you have not internet, you have not activity. It's a very important things, and when you learn psychiatry, we every time pay our attention to the dopaminergic pathway and serotoninergic pathway. Now some words about dopaminergic pathway. Usual dopaminergic pathway, it's a mesolimbic pathway, mesocortical pathway. This pathway has very high role in the in behavior. It's a pathway which has a very high role in the reward, in the delusions, in the hallucinations. Other two pathway, it's a tuberal fondatory pathway and nigrostriol pathway. Nigrostriol pathway has a very important role in the motor activity, and tuberal fondatory pathway has very important role into the realizing hormones. It's like a bridge between this pathway, it's a bridge between mental process, between cognitions, between hormones, and between motor activity. This picture explain more exactly, more clear, what does it mean mesolimbic and mesocortical pathway, what area of brain connect this pathway. It's a trigeminal area to nucleus accumbens, amygdala, hippocampus. Okay, now you understand. Hippocampus, it's a memory, yes. It's a prefrontal cortex, it's a cognitions, it's a amygdala, it's a fight or flight. Okay, now you understand. This pathway integrate our cognitions, integrate our animal phase, integrate our what emotions, like what's so good, what's so bad. And this pathway has a very high role in the mental diseases. When we speak about mental diseases which influence to the memory, which influence to the cognitions, influence to the emotions, usual this pathway take part a role on those pathology, and drugs very often influence to this pathway. Tuberal fondibulary pathway, it's connections between hypothalamus to pituitary gland. Yes, it's responsibility to the fight or flight, it's our animal phase, it's our metabolic process, it's sensory processing. I pay your attention, sensory processing information influence to our body conditions. Why information influence to the body conditions? We are pathway, because pathway connect sensory area of our nerve systems, or with area of nerve systems which responsibility for the releasing hormones. Hormones influence to the as a tissue and support metabolic process. Nigrostriatal pathway, it's a substance nigra to striatum. It's a motor control, and yes, of course, death of neurons in the in this pathway, developing Parkinson diseases, decreasing activity of neurons in this area, developing Parkinson's syndromes when we use drugs which decrease level of the dopamine. Because up to the drugs influence not only to the target pathway like mesolimbic and mesocortical pathway, influence to the cells which situated to the in the to the nigrostriatal pathway too. In this picture explain functions of the dopamine pathway. It's like a picture which integrate previous slides. I think you can stop video and watch this picture and remember this picture, because very often you can meet the same questions in exam. D2 receptors associated with antipsychotic medications. What's happy when we block D2 receptors into the brain? Different tract, different pathway, different effect. Idealistic drugs. What does mean idealistic drugs? Idealistic drugs, it's a drugs which be influenced only to symptoms without side effect. For example, if we has a antipsychotic drugs which decrease activity of the dopaminergic only into the mesolimbic pathway, we receive idealistic antipsychotic drugs. But in real life, it don't work. In our reality, drugs influence to the neurons which situated to the two other pathway, and as a result, we has elevated of the prolactin. Maybe you remember then dopamine. It's a natural inhibitors of the prolactin inhibitors, and motor disturbance. Why it's happy? It's happy because antipsychotic drugs influence to the cells which situated to which responsibility to the not only to the mesolimbic and mesocortical pathway, influence to the tuberofundibular neurons and neurons which create and nigrostriatal pathway, and it's a side effect. Next type of systems, it's a non-adrenergic systems. These systems has a very wide projections into the brain. Projections looks like dopaminergic systems. Some interesting fact about non-epinephrine systems. Non-epinephrine has projections into the amygdala, and as a result, a lot of drugs which responsibility which reduce anxiety symptoms influence to the non-epinephrine. Non-epinephrine has a role into the stress. Non-epinephrine stimulate release of the corticotropin released hormone, and yes, of course, this hormone influence has very high role into the stress, like into the fight or flight behavior. Peripheral non-epinephrine systems has very strong connections with autonomic nerve systems and somatic symptoms. Non-epinephrine responsibility for the somatic symptoms in somatic symptoms in anxiety disorders like a dry mouth, racing heart rate, sweating, and so on. Why it's happy? It's happy due non-epinephrine. In this picture, chemical structure and substance which influence to the synthesis of the neurotransmitters. When we speak about catecholamine, yes, of course, we discuss about tyrosine, yes, amino acids, and yes, of course, for support metabolism, we need some amino acids. We need food. Some words about serotonin. Serotonin, very important neurotransmitters and neurons, which main neurons, which responsibility for the 5-HT situated in the RFA nucleus. Serotonin neurons has a very important role into the sleep-wake-up cycles. And as a result, if patient has a mood problems, he has a problems with sleep, in like insomnia, mood, emotional control, food behavior. For example, for treatment patients with bulimia, we use drugs which stimulate serotoninergic systems. Thermoregulations, yes, of course, thermoregulations too. And has very strong connections with thyroid hormones. This picture explain and refresh information about synthesis of these neurotransmitters in our tissues. Like roots of these neurotransmitters, it's a tryptophan. Cardiovascular effect. Now very often we speak about using drugs which stabilize 5-HT transmissions in the cardiology. But we have a lot of type of receptors, and some type of receptors stimulate responsibility for the cardiology effect. Now you understand, then this receptor situated not only in the CNS, this receptor situated in the peripheral nerve systems, clear? And this picture explain some effect which has this effect when we stimulate 5-HT2A and 5-HT7 receptors and 2B receptors. It's very fresh information. Next very interesting role of the 5-HT, it's thrombogenesis, and it's a very important role. And you must remember, before surgery, a patient which has a tendency to the thrombosis and or to the blooding, you must control using of the drugs which influence to the 5-HT, like SSRI, serotonin self-repack inhibitors. Next very interesting roles of the 5-HT, it's like a headache. And now we use sumatriptan drugs which reduce headache due migraine. It's touch with 5-HT type 1 receptors, subtypes B, D, and F. And yes, of course, never use sumatriptan with, for example, SSRI drugs or other antidepressant drugs. If patients using sumatriptan, you must use a different type of the antidepressant agents, for example, valdexan, agomelatonin drugs, because those drugs don't work, so don't influence to the serotoninergic systems. In general, all antidepressant agents, it's agents which influence to the serotonergic systems. 5-HT has a very important role into the gastrointestinal tract. These receptors situated into the somatic nerve systems. Yes, it's a subtype of receptor number 3, subtype of receptor number 4. And as a result, side effect of the cross stimulations of receptors using antidepressant, very often side effect, it's a diarrhea, it's a motility. Serotonin pathway. I repeat once more. Serotonin pathway, it's a Raphe nucleus, yes. Neurons, main groups of the serotoninergic neurons, body of neurons, situated into the Raphe nucleus, and this pathway has a very wide projections. I repeat once more. These neurotransmitters and pathway has a very important role to the regulations of the temperature, sleep, mood, appetite, and pain. I pay your attention. In depressions, very often we have a phenomenon like a somatization in depressions. What does it mean somatization? It's a, like a painful feelings without, it's a painful feelings without somatic background, without objective problems, without objective problems. And obsessive compulsive disorders, very high role of the 5-HT and obsessive and serotoninergic pathway. Main first line treatment of the OCD, it's a drugs which increase level of the serotonin activity into the CNS. Very important pathway in medical, in everyday medical practice. Now this picture show a serotoninergic pathway. You see that projections of these neurons into the cerebellum, and as a result, very often patients with anxiety has a dizziness like important symptoms. Why it's happy? It's happy because in anxiety, decreasing changing level of the serotonin, and serotonin neurons has projections into the cerebellum. Yes, now you see that very high projections. And yes, of course, all of these systems has overlapping into the hypothalamus, into the amygdala, norepinephrine, dopamine, serotonin. All of these symptoms has same functions, but something different. It's need for balancing. It's need for balancing between, because our behavior, it's a very difficult systems. It's a very flexibility systems. Next, neurotransmitters. It's a GABA. GABA, and you remember, has a very large volume into the nerve systems. GABA and it's like a workhouse. Why? Because very lot of neurons, neuroglia work with these neurotransmitters. It's inhibitory neurotransmitters. These neurotransmitters decrease activity of neurons, like a decrease activity brain in general. When we want decrease activity of brain, we need to use drugs which stimulate GABA receptors. What is it's a type of drugs? It's a benzo. Yes, of course, it's a benzo. It's maybe valproate acid. It's maybe barbiturate. Drugs. When we want decrease activity of the brain, we stimulate GABA. Glutamate, it's other receptors which has a very high volume into the brain, and it's opposite, like a GABA inhibitory and glutamate stimulant. You know that glutamate, it's amino acid, yes, and And when we're eating, we receive this amino acid, and as a result, it stimulates our mood, stimulates our activity. A very interesting picture, which explains balancing between glutamate and GABA. Yes, GABA it's a alcohol. GABA is a stimulant alcohol. Yes, and coffee it's the opposite. GABA it's a stimulate alcohol stimulate GABA, and caffeine opposite, it's a decrease activity of the GABA systems. Yes, antagonist. And you see on this picture explain a balance between balloon and loading. For prepare of this lecture, I use some kind of books. These books you can receive in our department. Thank you very much for your attendance. I am Professor Alexander Dvirsky. Thank you for your attention. Thank you for your attendance. Goodbye. Good morning, dear colleagues. I hope video and audio high quality. Are you listening to me? Are you seeing me?
Что-что? Не поняла.
Okay, everything fine. Okay, now we start our lecture. Schizophrenia, biological facts. I am Professor Alexander Dvirsky, Department of Psychiatry and Psychology. Today we will discuss about schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is a great enigma of up-to-date medicine. Why is schizophrenia its enigma? First, schizophrenia is a mental disorder. Now I repeat once more, what does mean mental disorders? Mental disorders, it's a problems in it's a disturbance in mental process and behavior without general medical conditions. What does it mean? It means patients has a serious problems in behavior, in mental process like thinking, like emotions, like maybe intelligent cognitions, without general medical conditions. What does it mean without general medical conditions? It's mean up to date technology don't show anything. From clinical medicine, this patient has a perfect health. MRI, perfectly. Biochemical examinations, perfectly. Everything's perfectly. But what essential in mental diseases? Patient has a serious problems in behavior, in everyday living. What I mean in everyday living, I mean it's all kind of activity. It's social relations. It's social promotions. It's functions. It's like self support. But mental diseases usually destroy this area. Before today's lecture, I want. Refreshing your mind some terms. First, terms. It's hallucinations. What does it mean, hallucinations? Hallucinations, it's a pathology of perceptions. Perceptions, it's a complex, it's a complex feelings in which we recognize nature and nature locations and properties of the stimuli. Perception possible with or without signal. It means when we're dreaming about something, it's a perception. Pathology of perceptions, it's illusions and hallucinations. Illusions, it's a wrong perceptions, it's a wrong recognizing of signal. I paid your attention, we discuss about recognizing. In perception, we recognize something. It means we see something, we recognize something. Sensations, it's a stream of data. Perception, it's a recognizing of something. We understand what we see, what we feel. Maybe it's auditory perception, maybe it's a visual perception, gustatory, olfactory, tactility. It's a pathology of perception, it's a hallucinations. What has been hallucinations? Hallucinations, it's a recognizing of some signal, recognizing of some signal without signal. It's mean patients register some signal, but in reality, this physical signal are absent. Second definitions which I want to refresh in your mind, it's delusions. Delusions, it's a pathology of delusions, it's a pathology of thinking. What does it mean thinking? Thinking, it's a mental process. Due to thinking, we reasoning, categorizing, compare some mental representations. Yes, in general, thinking, it's manipulations with mental with perception image. Perception image, it's a perception, it's a cognitive process. What does it mean cognitions? Cognitions, it's our ability create networks from the different neuronal events. It's mean we can create in one event everything which around ourselves, which we see, which we listen about what we reading some times ago. We integrate like current time, former time, and future. It's a networks from all event. Cognitive ability, it's ability to create one you need from everything in our mind. In our mind, I pay your attention now. I use terms mind. You remember that present brain and mind. Brain, it's the organs, functions of brain. It's a mind. Mind, it's a mental process. Okay, what pathology of thinking usual do you know? First, it's a delusions. What does mean delusions? Delusions, it's a false belief which developing in illness background. What I mean when I speak about illness background? I mean mental disorders, mental problems, or I mean somatic problems. For example, a patient has a wrong conclusions. He thinks that somebody prescriptory but he has a brain lesions. It's mean delusions due general medical conditions, due brain trauma. Other situations, patient think about prescriptorious, but himself, he thinks that everybody pay attention to him, but we cannot register any pathology due clinical examinations. It's mean why patient has these delusions. Patient has these delusions because he has a formal disorders of thought. For example, his thinking process work not so perfectly. For example, he has a paralogic thinking, he has a magic thinking, maybe he has a overvalued ideas like maybe due mania. Yeah, due mania, he has a grandiosity idea, he thinks that he is a center of the world. Other problems. Now I hope you understand. And in when we speak about delusions, you must recognize other problems in mental area or other problems in health. If patient has the wrong conclusions, it's only freedom of thinking. Clear? It's a freedom of thinking. But if patient has a wrong conclusions which not share with environment, and he has other problems in health and other problems in or other problems in mentality, it's a delusions, because in definitions of delusions we has a very important keywords. It's a wrong conclusions which unshare with social appearance, which developing in illness background, clear, illness background as a pathology. Okay, now we do small review about psychopathology. Now some word about schizophrenia. First definitions. What does mean schizophrenia? The schizophrenia are characterized by fundamental characteristic disorders of thinking, perceptions, willpower and affect. I pay your attention. What does mean schizophrenia? Schizophrenia destroy thinking, schizophrenia destroy perception functions, and schizophrenia destroy willpower and affect. What does mean willpower? Willpower, it's our ability to do something. What has been our willpower? For example, you wake up in the morning and you don't want to visit class, but you're coping, you stand up and visit class. It's a willpower push you. Willpower push you from bed to the class. Clear? It's a willpower. What's happy in schizophrenic patients? In schizophrenic patients, patient has a lack of willpower. Patient like has a motivations, he wants something, but he have not enough energy to do something. What's happy in affect? Usual affect mood disorders, it's a bipolar disorders, it's a depression, it's a syndromes like a mania, like depressions. But what happy in in schizophrenia? In schizophrenia, patient has a flat affect. What is in flat affect? He has every time he has same emotion, normal emotions. He don't change emotion to everything. Clear? For example, sometimes you're happy, sometimes you feel a negative emotions. But patient with schizophrenia has a same emotional relations to everything. And as a result, he cannot compare two events. For what purpose we need emotions? We need emotions because emotions, it's like a price. What does it mean good for ourselves? What does it mean bad for ourselves? It's a price, clear. But what's happy in schizophrenic patients? Schizophrenic patients every time feel same relations to everything, clear. Sometimes patients do very strange things, very strange crime. For example, he kill parents because they disturb him see a TV show. What's happened in these situations? Why he do murders? Because life, people's life and TV show has equal emotions, clear. We use emotions for compare to object. When you do choice, you compare emotions, your relation to something. Without emotions, you cannot compare. You cannot compare to object. And as a result, yes, of course, it's influenced to the cognitions. It's not directly influenced to cognitions like a thinking. It's influenced to cognitions too. But I pay your attention. Patient has problems in thinking. In our definitions, we see that schizophrenia, it's a disease which characterizes by some fundamental changes in thinking. In thinking, it's a pathology of thinking in structure and content. Content, it's delusion. Structure, it's a problems like a paralogic thinking, like a symbolic thinking, like a autistic thinking and other pathology. I pay your attention. Patients with schizophrenia has a clear consciousness. What does it mean consciousness? Consciousness, it's our ability to orientations in the time, place and situations. Usual consciousness problems, it's problems due to general medical conditions. In schizophrenia, problems in consciousness possible only sometimes in very strange symptoms. Usual, it's aneroid, but it's now we don't speak about the symptoms. Maybe it's like a result of some side effect of the drugs, like NMS, neurological malignant syndromes. Patient with schizophrenia has some cognitive problems, but these problems not like a dementia. It's less problems, less than dementia, but these problems possible and present. Main symptoms of schizophrenia. What's main symptoms of schizophrenia? Concept of the main and additional symptoms. What has been main symptoms? Main symptoms, it's a symptoms which depend diagnosis schizophrenia. It's mean symptoms which must have all schizophrenic patients. I pay your attention. Delusions and hallucinations, it's not a main symptoms, because present lot of other diseases and conditions which include delusions and hallucinations like symptoms. But in schizophrenia, fundamental problems, it's a flatness affect. Yeah, I repeat once more, flatness affect, it's mean patient has same relations to everything. Formal disorders of thought. Formal disorders of thought, it's a very strange problems in thinking. It's like autistic thinking, it's like a reasoning thinking, it's like a problems in the mechanic of thinking. Autism, what does it mean autism? Autism, it's a patient has a wide internal worlds, but he has a lack of activity in reality. Why it's happy? It's happy because patient has some motivations, but patient have not enough willpower. Yeah, not enough willpower. You see that problems with power, willpower problems like apatia present in a list of the main symptoms. In additional, very, very interesting symptoms, it's ambivalence. It's like a splitting of the emotional response. What does it mean, ambivalence? It's mean a patient has two opposite emotions in same time. For example, patient has love feelings and angry feelings to something. Maybe he's splitting opposite. He like homeless peoples, but he don't like parents. He like pets and he every time don't like parents. Clear? It's like opposite, like inversions of emotion area. Very strange. Okay, I repeat once more. Main symptoms, it's a symptoms which has which depends schizophrenia. It's a flatness effect. It's a formal disorders of thought. It's a autism. It's a ambivalence. It's a pathology of willpower, like apathy, abulia. Secondary symptoms, it's symptoms which depend a type of schizophrenia. Like core symptoms, we discussed something before. It's ambivalence, it's apathy, it's a flatness effect, it's a formal disorders of thought. It's main symptoms. Without main symptoms, we cannot take diagnosis schizophrenia. For example, secondary symptoms, it's delusions, hallucinations, catatonic symptoms. Patient has hallucinations. It's not a schizophrenic patient. Patient has hallucinations more than 6 months. It's not a schizophrenic patient. Why? Because maybe patient has hallucinations due chronic alcohol intoxications. Delusions. Patients maybe has delusions long time, but he have not problems with willpower. He have not problems with thinking. He have not problems with affect. It's only delusional disorders. You understand? Delusions and hallucinations. Yes, of course, delusions and hallucinations, it's a paranoid syndromes. It's a paranoid, but it's not a schizophrenia. Other situations, patient has a formal disorders of thought. Patient has a flatness effect. Patient has hallucinations and delusions. It's a schizophrenic patient. Why is a schizophrenic patient? It's a patient. It's a schizophrenic patient because patient has symptoms. Patient has symptoms, main and secondary. Main symptoms and secondary symptoms. Clear? I hope now you understand concept of the main and secondary symptoms. We never take diagnosis schizophrenia for patients without main symptoms. Next concept, positive negative symptoms. What does it mean? It's an old concept. Now we don't use directly these symptoms, but maybe 50 years ago it was like a main concept in schizophrenia. Negative symptoms. It's a symptoms which we don't see. It's a, like a allergia for mood disorders of thought, flatness effect, apathy, problems with associating, apparent of attention. It's a symptoms which we don't see. Patient lying in the bed and have not contact with reality. Autistic symptoms, yes. It's a patient which don't pay attention to the himself. Positive symptoms. Positive symptoms, it's a symptoms which attract attention, like a hallucinations. Patients running around and speak about aliens attack. Why he speak about aliens attack? Because he has a delusions. Why he has a delusions? He has a delusions because he listen voice which promise aliens attack in his mind. Patients has delusions and hallucinations. It's a positive symptoms. It's like a patients take bizarre behavior. He has a bizarre behavior due hallucinations, due delusions. These symptoms pay attention. These symptoms concentrate attention. Positive formal disorders of thought possible. Catatonia, yes, of course. Catatonia, it's a neurological symptoms, but catatonia possible not only in schizophrenia. Catatonia possible in other disorders, like in the depressions, in the bipolar disorders, in the schizoaffective disorders. Okay, now you understand concept. Negative symptoms, it's a symptoms which decrease patient activity, not ask attention, and positive symptoms, it's a symptom which added some new element in patient's behavior, in patient's say-so functions. History of schizophrenia. First person which recognized these strange symptoms, it was Emil Kraepelin. Emil Kraepelin recognized strange diseases, which he recognized like a dementia in a young age. He called a dementia praecox, it means young dementia. I hope you understand. Usual dementia starting in the old age, but a lot of people has dementia in the young age. What's happy? Why Kraepelin, Emil Kraepelin recognized schizophrenia like a dementia? You remember that patient with schizophrenia has a problems not only like a delusion and hallucinations, he has a problems with formal disorders of thought, with kind of cognitions. And schizophrenia starting in the young age. And he recognizes diseases like dementia praecox, like a dementia which starting in the young age. But what's phenomena? He not recognize any problems in autopsy in these patients. In dementia, usual neurologists recognize a lot of organic problems into the brain. In these diseases, patient has dementia in the young age, and technology and autopsy don't show anything in patient's brain after mortality research. After some times, next author Bleuler, Eugen Bleuler, calls this dementia praecox like a schizophrenia. Why? Because he recognized not only problems with cognitions, he recognized problems with emotions, he recognized ambivalence and other psychopathological phenomena, and he calls this disease schizophrenia, like a split consciousness, split mind. Yes, of course, this name, my opinion, based in symptoms which has name ambivalence, when patient has two opposite emotions, which has patient has like a inversion of emotions. Evidence of the biological base of the schizophrenia. Up-to-date tendency in the psychiatry, we try shift all mental diseases to the neurological diseases, to organic diseases. What's different between mental and neurological diseases? Mental diseases, it's a disorders. Mental diseases, it's a disorders. It's a disturbance in behavior and mental process without general medical conditions. And why we not cannot recognize general medical conditions? Because up-to-date technology not enough for recognize the sensitive changes in the brain, in metabolic process, in schizophrenia, in depressions, in bipolar disorders. But now we has some biological fact which evidence that schizophrenia it's not a disease of soul, it's a usual organic disease. What problems has schizophrenic patients? Like atrophy of the prefrontal cortex, enlarged ventriculus, hippocampus thalamus atrophy. But I pay you attention, what's problems in this changing? Not specific. A lot of other conditions and patients has same changings without schizophrenia. But yes, of course, numerous of patients which has schizophrenia and these changings very high. What does it mean? It means that we cannot take diagnosis schizophrenia analyzing only MRI, CT, and other high technology method. But when we has a patient which looks like a schizophrenic patient, when we has a patient which has schizophrenic symptoms, and same patient has this list of changings in MRI, it's like evidence our diagnosis schizophrenia. Second problems, it's a strong genetic loading. It's mean a nearest proband, nearest relatives from the proband. Proband is somebody from which we create a genealogical tree, has a more high rate to developing schizophrenia. Neurochemical abnormalities. Neurochemical abnormalities, it's a problems in the dopamine and other neurotransmitters. And we use this abnormality for treatment schizophrenia. We use usual drugs which influence to the metabolism in the brain, which change metabolic process in neurotransmitter into the brain. Normal schizophrenic brain, it's not a one brain, it's a statistically. It's like a changings, it's a changing, it's not a one brain. It's a lot of schizophrenic brain, it's a lot of patients without schizophrenia. It's a function MRI, it's a function MRI. You see that functions of the brain has a changings, but it's not specific changings. If you use this method for one patient, you cannot recognize schizophrenia. But in large groups, we see it's a different brain, clear. But if you do only one research in one patient, you cannot take diagnosis schizophrenia using only MRI. You must using mental state examinations. Same picture. It's a statistic. It's not one patient. It's you can meet a lot of like this picture in the internet. Next classic picture. Two monozygotic twins, one twins affected due schizophrenia, other not affected due schizophrenia. Patient which affected due schizophrenia and large ventriculus. Other patients ventriculus like a normal. Other picture, same idea. Patients which affected due schizophrenia has absolutely different brain structure, but it's a monozygote twins. It's mean some, but it's not specific changings. It's not specific changings because possible same picture in brain without schizophrenia. Next abnormality. It's normal in schizophrenic patients, but it's not specific changings. We cannot take diagnosis in post-mortality research using only this picture. Genetic and schizophrenia. Many psychiatric disorders are multifactorial. What has been polygene or multifactorial disorders? It's mean a lot of gene depend diseases. These diseases has a lot of a very wide clinical picture. For example, monogene disorders has one picture, clinical picture, and very all clinical picture very same, like phenylketonuria, like I don't know, other gene disorders, picture very same. In schizophrenia, we has a lot of clinical picture, like we has patients with simple schizophrenia, catatonic schizophrenia, like cambiphrenic schizophrenia, paranoid schizophrenia, different cause of schizophrenia, progredient, recurrent schizophrenia, a lot of type of schizophrenia. Why it's happy? It's happy because a lot of gene depend symptoms. Now see to this picture. If schizophrenia depend only by gene, monozygote twins must have a 100% of the schizophrenia, but only near the 50%. What does it mean? Two monozygote twins, one brother has schizophrenia, other without schizophrenia. But you understand that two brother or two sister has absolutely same genetic and present some other factors which start schizophrenia. These diseases, it's like a combinations between environmental factors and environmental factors and biological vulnerability. Biological vulnerability hereditary from one generation to other generations, but we don't know what external factor starts schizophrenia. My opinion, this picture very good in the family consultations, because very often you will receive questions. For example, my husband has schizophrenia. What ratio of the schizophrenia in my child? Answer to these questions present in this picture. Thank you very much. I am Professor Alexander Dvirsky. Thank you for your attendance. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye. Okay, dear colleagues, I think lecture was not so difficult for you. In next lecture, we discuss about type of schizophrenia and other clinical features. Today, it was like an enter in the schizophrenia. On the next lecture, we discuss about more deep about schizophrenia. Okay, goodbye.